Holy fuck! That was diabolical!
Ooh, bacon.
Hey, Baconians, welcome back to my channel's Reverse BLT here, and I'm about to watch episode 5 of The Boys, Good for the Soul. Episode 4 whooped my ass a little bit emotionally. I think I might have to start keeping a box of Kleenex next to me when I watch this show because it hit me right in the feels in multiple scenes.
My emotions! My emotions!
I think that whole thing with the plane is probably going to stick with me throughout this show. I still am not over Homelander just letting all those people die like that. He's not going to be able to cover that up for long. I mean, once they recover the black box and start checking the passengers and everything, it's going to become pretty clear that he was there. I have no idea what he's going to do next. After that comes out, the jig is going to be up. And speaking of jigs being up,
nobody talks like that.
We had a dumbass, the Deep, going on a very half-cocked, alcohol-fueled rescue attempt for one of the dolphins at the this universe's version of SeaWorld, I guess. Trying to rescue it, and that just went sideways in the most epic fashion. And so I'm sure there's going to be significant fallout for that, and I'm curious to see how that's going to play out. Huey had his first date with Starlight, but it was kind of messed up by guilt over Robin, which makes sense. I mean, somebody's going to carry with him forever, but if at some point you have to move on. And like I said previously, I think it's probably been at least a year now.
Wrong.
And I don't think that she would want him to stay alone for the rest of his life. She didn't seem like that type of person. So, I don't know. And Annie seems like a real sweetheart, like a genuine sweetheart. So I'm already shipping them. But anyway, let's go ahead and get into this. We have the female who was recovered by the boys. And I have a feeling that contrary to what Butcher and Mother's Milk think, I think she is going to be one of the Spice Girls. And I want to see how that plays out. I really want her to be part of the team. So let's go ahead and get into this. Episode 5. Let's go.
Still well. She's open to us going public.
Don't you lie to me.
Hand on a Bible.
Hey, Train, what are you fucking with there?
But listen, for us to go public, you have to come clean with me. Like, I have to know who you told about Compound B.
I don't know their names, but there was this British guy. Dark hair, real smug asshole, buzz cut French guy, big black guy with a goatee, and a skinny white kid. I think they were all working together.
I'm gonna kill you.
Most first dates order like a scallop.
I'm so tense.
You got a dark beer, a New York strip, and a chocolate chip cheesecake. I remember thinking, here's someone who isn't afraid to be happy. And I fell for you right then and there.
Jesus Christ, this is about to get incredibly fucked up. The heroin? Just basically give her an instant overdose?
You've been shooting it up for weeks. You really think I wouldn't notice?
I'm done, man. Nah, I'm fucking done. Cold turkey.
Really?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
I wonder if who's faster.
Hey. Come on.
No.
I love you.
Never. Family. Embrace a man who could crush you to
I'll
death.
Always be watching over you.
Threat.
Always. And the misplaced Asian girl.
I'll find her.
Fuck.
So very good use of smash cut.
Massage the bird with olive oil. Then I
Man, is there anything you can't
pepper.
Do, Frenchie?
Then I bake. Basting every 20 minutes to keep it from drying out is very important. It's crisp, but not too crunchy.
Oh, damn it. Now I'm hungry. Damn you, Frenchie!
Tell me what you know, Monka, so we can find these fuckers who did this to you. so I can get you back home.
She clearly doesn't want to go home. Maybe stop saying back home.
Stamping feet and hearts are proud. Building like a thundercloud.
This would be a fucking nightmare for me. It's the only negative for Starlight so far. That's pretty cool. Are those real? Is she a super with wings?
They're only letting me wear this one because apparently it's family friendly.
I prefer that outfit.
My mom and I, we would drive coast to coast in her brown Honda Civic. Just doing the whole Christian circuit thing. You know, Power Fest, Capes for Christ.
No offense, Christians. Just not my bag. Like, not even close to being my bag.
After everything that's happened, it's really nice to see them again.
I mean, I'm not against the good parts of the message. Like, you know, be nice to people and loving and all that kind of stuff. It's just been my experience that not very many people really follow it. And of course, I don't believe in the mythology.
Mom, this is Huey. He's a friend.
Hi. How nice.
Starlight. You hydrating?
I love PR, lady. That's what we love about you.
You know what? I'll let you go ahead. Go round table those teens. Mm. We'll catch up later.
This is the thing that irritates me the most about religion is how commoditized it is. Everybody's got something to fucking sell.
Jesus said, hey, bro. Hey, bro, bring it in. You shouldn't need proof. You should just believe because I say so, because you have faith.
I hate these kinds of people. I mean, the televangelist guy.
Why can Jesus walk on water? Why does Homelander fly?
These are all supers, I guess? Jesus was a super, you heard it here first. Even though there's no historical evidence that he even existed. Don't at me. Or you can at me if you actually know of some historical evidence. Josephus doesn't count.
We were born with his power because we believe.
You were born with his power because you believe? So you believe before you were born? What?
Isn't that an easier, cheaper way for us to get to him?
We ain't getting to Ezekiel.
They love having these conversations in public.
And just go up to Ezekiel. Hey, man, what's up with you smuggling blue dope into Chinatown basements?
Yeah, pretty much, once you show him this.
Jesus.
Oh, that you worry about in public.
Why is this the first time I'm hearing about this plan? This kid needs to be trained up, Butcher.
Yeah. Yeah, what he said. I don't know how to blackmail anybody.
Huey, you've done a murder. Comparatively speaking, this will be a piece of cake.
We're here today to remember the victims of Transoceanic Flight 37. 123 brave souls lost in an instant in a senseless act of violence.
It just feels like something horrible is about to happen. And this show deals a lot with PTSD. A lot.
Susan Lopez from Evanston and her daughter, Maya. Samuel Brown, a teacher of physics from Los Angeles. We're all truly sorry for your loss. You remember that nut job in Albany last year? Killed his wife. Then he came out of the house with a gun at his daughter's head. Remember that? Cops pissing their pants, didn't know what to do. And then you step up very calmly, ask for the sergeant's big pen, and fling it 26 yards right into the asshole's eyeball. Dead shot, dead shooter.
What's your point?
My point is that you took action. That's what I love about you, Maeve.
And that's what we love about you.
Nobody wanted that airplane to go down the way it did. Of course not. And now, we gotta make the best of it. Otherwise, it was all for nothing.
What's my phone beeping for? You're on Do Not Disturb. I can't get over how great of an actor the guy playing Homelander is.
I have this friend from my soccer team, Sanji.
Friend.
She's Hindu. I know who it's kind of my responsibility, I guess, to get her to accept Jesus.
Oh, they're evangelicals.
Well, Jesus also says to love your neighbor.
But if you love your neighbor, don't you want to save them from damnation? You have to look at it as good news. You have a chance to help your friend find eternal life, right?
Did you have...
the sex?
Sex with him? Well, I...
You know, Creature Boy is so scared right now.
Everyone hopes that their first is the one. And it's private, but... I'm a virgin. Yeah, I'm saving myself for my future husband.
Oh, God, I hate this shit so much.
Let the bed be undefiled, for God will judge the sexually immoral. Okay.
Jesus said if you even think about sex, that you've basically committed the sin, so...
I'm saying, if there is some geezer out there with a big white beard, he's a real heavyweight cunt.
I'm sorry, did you... just call God a C-word?
Yeah, he's got a hard-on for mass murder and giving kids cancer. And his big old answer to the existential clusterfuck that is humanity is to nail his own bleeding son to a plank. That is a cunt move. Come on, even you got to agree with me. Hey.
I'm with Billy on this one.
You're going straight to hell, you know.
He also had a bunch of kids butchered by bears because they made fun of a guy being bald. I mean, there's a lot of fucked up shit in the Bible.
You believe in God?
I mean, I don't know.
What? Come off it.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think it's Morgan Freeman up there or anything.
But... what's with the fly? Okay, seriously, that's the... there's something going on with this fucking fly, dude. That was way too deliberate, way too focused on, and I even think it was a CGI fly.
Well, I'm pretty sure I wasn't supposed to lie to them, Mom.
Oh, baby. You're Starlight of the Seven. Millions of kids are looking up to you now.
Yeah. Teach them how to love themselves.
You okay?
Fine. It's just, this place isn't what I remember.
Oh, are you starting to grow up, Starlight? Huey, you need to see a shrink, buddy.
Is there any way you could hook me up with one of those Diamond Club passes? You know, to see Ezekiel.
Ezekiel?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it's not going to make sense.
My dad is like Ezekiel's number one fan.
Hmm.
So what do you think? Pull a few strings, you know? Hook me up with some tickets.
Yeah. Sure, that's, of course.
That made me sad. Now she feels like she's being used.
She's not wrong.
And also she's suspicious of him now. Because being a superhero is at least partially about being a detective. Homelander's starting to feel like somebody on the very knife's edge of a nervous breakdown.
Keep believing.
Grab Madeline. I need to talk to her about these fucking talking points.
Miss Stowell isn't here today. I thought that you knew that. But I'm here to help you with anything. I'll go through the talk.
Where is she?
I think he feels very jealous of her kid.
What are you doing here?
Skipping work now?
I am taking Teddy to the pediatrician.
That baby is an accessory.
And he's a child losing his shit at his parents. Or his mom. He hates that baby so much. He's gonna hurt that fucking baby. I don't understand people who don't have peepholes in their doors.
You?
My mom's getting old. She just wants a place to talk to her daughter.
Yeah, well, she's talking to dirt, isn't she?
It's something.
I mean, you're always talking to dirt. Once they're dead, they're gone. I love how they change, Oh, okay, I get it. It's a movie. I was literally saying, they changed the stuff, the filming style. Different types of scenes, but
and I did not kill
it's a movie.
Dr. Robinson, I wouldn't mind you. I love you, baby.
Love is just another lie, Donovan.
Why are you torturing yourself, buddy? Seriously, why do people in guys in movies always go to the sex parts for their memories about their loved ones? Oh, was this recording when they came in to talk to her?
All right, easy. Easy, that's it. We ain't here to hurt you.
Who are you?
Oh, fuck. The jig is completely up now. You remember seeing him at the subway. Man, this show is really good at just ratcheting the tension up. The stakes are getting higher and higher.
Starlight's friend. He got you in here.
Yeah.
There you go. Good to meet you, pal.
Meet you.
How do you know Starlight?
You know, we met, like, a few weeks ago, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
And she got you in here?
Yeah, I guess she did.
Well, this is a pricey ticket, Huey. Must be a special guy.
No, I'm not. I just feel lucky to be here, really.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome you one and all, and I would very much like to welcome Homelander, our special guest. So, without further ado, if you would follow me.
Pretty sure it's without further ado, like A-D-O, but everyone always says it like it's ado, A-D-I-E-U.
Homelander is an ordained minister in Samaritan's Embrace.
What?
Together.
I don't know why I
we
find that
will
hilarious.
Be rebaptizing you, my most loyal followers.
Fun fact, I've been baptized 8 times. It's a weird thing for an atheist, huh?
Something wrong, Huey?
No. No, I'm totally comfortable. Why would you ask that?
Well, your blood pressure is 150 over 90. It's a bit high.
Okay, so he's very intelligent. Because even with powers, you would have to be able to think and calculate very quickly to be able to figure out someone's blood pressure just from sensing it.
Then I baptize you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
He's so good.
May I speak with you just for a moment?
Sorry, son, I got a packed schedule.
Yeah, seduce him.
Just hold on. 1 second, let me just show you something.
Did you have that in your pocket while you were getting back? Oh, for fuck's sakes, Huey! He really does need some training. What?
Yeah, in a private soup club. You played my butt like jazz. With poise and skill and willingness to improvise.
Well, he thinks on his feet!
I have the video of the three of us sucking and fucking. And if you don't let me go, my friend puts the video online like that.
What do you want? You want a little bit of money? Are you here for money?
You ship boxes labeled as polio vaccine, but they're not really polio vaccine, are they? They're Compound V.
Who the hell are you?
I want to know everything about them. Okay, you tell me where they're going, and you tell me how many boxes you ship.
No. No, they will destroy me.
Who's they? Bot?
Wow. This is so big that he's willing to risk being outed.
And tell over me. It. Are they a video? Trends, number one on Twitter. Tonight. And you're also gonna stop the fucking pray the gay away shit.
I hate hypocrites. So I'm glad he threw that in there.
Yeah, it's me. Sorry, I had to borrow a phone. Thanks again. I got baptized.
You borrowed a phone and you called him on it? Guys are so bad at this.
You are a natural, kid. You're like the fucking Rain Man of fucking people over.
Not a compliment.
I guess Homelander doesn't use his super hearing all the time, eh? No, look who needs an empty piece of dirt to talk to. Oh, okay, never mind. Man, you fucking suck, Butcher. He needs to learn that not everything is about him. You just took away her family's peace.
Some people...
They want me to come out here...
Right at the camera.
...empty platitudes to you all.
I answer to a higher law. Wasn't I chosen to save you? Is it not my God-given purpose
to are you about to do, Homelander? Well,
fuck.
That didn't go as planned.
Hey, Maeve, what,
sister, lover, what?
Sorry, what are you?
I was, stopping a mugging nearby, and I... It's good to see you. Can I come in?
Okay, I'm getting lover vibes. Or, well, ex-lover, I guess.
You've been drinking? No. You're not going to meetings anymore.
No, she's a recovering alcoholic.
I'm sorry. Okay, I'm really sorry. I didn't mean...
I don't want your apology, okay? I want you to get out. Okay? I want you to go back to your ivory penthouse where you
this cast is so talented.
Whoever you want. Go back to Homelander. Back. Oh.
It's interesting that she's affected by alcohol.
Tell me what happened.
Oh no. Another person is about to become collateral damage. Oh no.
No, Maeve. If this isn't... No, this is... You're obviously... No, I said stop it. Just talk to me. Okay? Just tell me what happened.
Don't do it, Maeve. I know you want to unburden yourself, but don't drag this poor girl into this.
A mistake. No, just talk to me. Just tell me what... If you...
And I remember what Homelander said to her about if he ever found out she was with somebody else. I wouldn't be surprised if the bastard's tailing her. He's going to assume she said something, probably.
So you want to pay me the professional courtesy and tell me where the hell you disappeared to before?
How the fuck did that work?
I'm burned.
Well, what about the rest of us?
Your concern for me is very sweet.
What about the girl? Fucking labor.
There are cameras everywhere
God
in a hospital.
God knows what they'll do to her.
So unsuit violence ain't our concern, mate.
It was the Heartland Beauties, luck of the Irish pageant. The lights went out on stage. And this one lit up the room with the glow from her hands.
She blind anybody doing that?
Tell him I'm not going on. I've waited 23 years for this.
This isn't about you.
Isn't it? All my friends are going to be watching on TV. Please.
What a bitch. Look, if you become a parent, it's not about you anymore. It's about your fucking child.
And we the same, you and I. Like eggs. Hard outside, soft inside, or pineapples, perhaps. Whatever those bastards got planned for you, you don't deserve it, Monka.
I'm gonna weep when he dies, I know that. He's a good guy deep down inside, even though he is a bad guy. And I assume she's probably gonna die too, because they're starting to give her a redemption arc. Or, I mean, I don't know if it's a redemption arc, but you know, they're giving her an arc that will allow her to become more and more human. And judging by the way this show operates so far, they're only doing that so they can really make us suffer later. Caged animal's gonna run.
Did you know that my first public appearance was right here on this very stage with Ezekiel and the rest of the family?
I'm glad I never became famous.
I wanted to share with you how it
seems like it'd be a nightmare.
Christ as my personal savior. How his way is the only way.
That's some fascist shit right there.
Every single word that I say up here, I'm reading from a script. I didn't write any of these words. I don't even know if I believe in them. It's just how goddamn certain everyone is around here. Tickets start at what, $170? So that
this could play very well.
Tell you how to get into heaven. What? If you're gay or if you're Gandhi, you're going to hell? I mean, and if you have sex before marriage, that's not immoral. That's human. What's immoral is the guy who shoved his dick in my face.
Oh, she's actually going to come clean about this right here? Wow. I love her. Starlight is precious and must be protected.
Here's the truth. Anyone who tells you they know the answers is lying. And I know, I'm supposed to be this hero, idol, symbol, whatever, but I don't know what the hell I'm doing. I'm just as scared and confused as the rest of you. I'm done pretending. And I'm done taking any more shit.
Oh, be very afraid, Deep. Be very afraid. I think maybe I could date that type of Christian. Doesn't hurt that she's gorgeous.
Velvy? Oh yeah, and lots of it.
So they are making supers.
Jesus,
that's a fucking baby soup. These cunts are made in a fucking lab.
So that's why it gets shipped all over to different hospitals. Every soup is manufactured.
How was your quality time with Ezekiel? Huh? Any more VIP
Come
tickets?
Tell her
I can
the
get
truth.
For you because I'm so here for you.
It's not like that.
You sure? Because I can get you a commemorative cup or a goodie bag.
My girlfriend died. I really don't think there's anything that could help it anymore or fix it or make it better. Everything I heard here, well, that helped a total of jack shit. Except for what you said.
Now, he is. No, that would be inappropriate right now. Or maybe that is going to happen. I don't know.
I'm so sorry.
No. I'm sorry.
That's a really nice, sweet moment.
You get some air in there, you could kill a kid.
Well, wouldn't that be a crying shame?
Jesus Christ, dude, you're so fucking racist. I get you don't like soups, but it's not like they meant to be this.
Hey.
Jesus Christ.
Holy fuck! That was diabolical!
Oh my god.
You done good, lad.
Big takeaway for me here is that Vought or somebody knows how to make glass that
now you keep your nose clean, sunshine.
Resists the oh, super's god, laser slash heat vision. So she knows he does that.
You've been out there quite a lot lately. Always watching. So why don't you just come on inside? You afraid of
me? Play a higher level of game? You are afraid of her, though. I'm beginning to think Homelander is a virgin, and a lot of this is edible, in a way.
Are you lonely? It must be hard, feeling so alone. I'm sorry. But you cannot give a speech like that. You cannot be bad.
The music is turning some screws right now. There's definitely some edible shit going on here. Even though I don't think that Stillwell is his actual literal mother.
Come here.
So I learned that this was Elizabeth Shue and I was shocked because I did not recognize her at all. Still a great actress. She's definitely improved with age.
Oh, You have to be good.
He's both comforted and confused right now.
And then we both can get what we want.
A little drink from the nipple. That's a dangerous game you're playing, Madeline.
You're my good boy.
So if Black Noir really is like Batman, then he's gonna get him. Where's the speedster? Thanks for the assist. Oh, he's an expert combatant, though. Come on, Frenchie. She helped you. You gotta help her. I'm guessing that she's gonna essentially be like Wolverine. Because it seems too early to have this character exit.
No.
Yeah, I love you for coming back, Frenchie, but it was a dumb move. Yeah, Wolverine slash X2. She the first suit with regenerative. The show just keeps picking up steam. Stillwell's playing an extremely dangerous game with trying to manipulate Homelander on a deeper level now. I think she has known for a long time he's fixated on her. And I guess maybe she's been keeping this particular card in reserve to play on him, basically roping it into a full-on sort of sexual thing now. Rather than just using the fact that he has a sort of a mommy attachment to her just to keep him under control. Now I think she's taking it to the next level. Extremely dangerous. That's like sticking your hand inside the mouth of an alligator because you're sure that it's not going to bite you. I have a feeling it's going to bite her on the ass big time.
Correct!
We got to learn a lot about the female today in this episode. She is, yeah, basically, it's funny how every character, every soup anyway, is essentially sort of like a riff on an established famous superhero from comic books. And so she clearly is essentially Wolverine. You know, she's very feral, or X2, very feral, healing factor, strong, seems to have sharp claws of some kind or something. So yeah, I'm going to put her into the Wolverine category for now. Black Noir definitely obviously is Batman, but not as smart as Batman, because I don't think Batman would have just left the scene like that, just assuming everything was over, because he didn't know whether there was a connection between the guy he was hunting and the girl he was hunting. So the smart thing to do would have been to wait around and see if maybe the guy he was hunting came back, because they need information from that guy. They know that I don't know if Black Noir knows that he knows about Compound V. I don't know how close that's being kept to the vest. It would make sense to limit how many people know. But then again, I don't know also whether all the soups have to take it. So there's a lot of unanswered questions there. They kind of make it impossible to really figure out, you know, what the distribution of information about what exactly is happening right now is, you know. But conversation between Homelander and A-Train made it seem like it's basically just those two who really know what's the reason for hunting these people down. So that's what I'm going to operate with. Homelander was his typical terrifying self. That actor, I swear I'm going to look it up, because if he did not win some Emmys for this, I have no faith in the people who give out Emmys anymore. Because his performance is fantastic. It's nuanced and just terrifying in an extremely subtle way for the most part. You know, you can really see what's going on in his head. But you can also see that he's trying to make sure other people can't see it. And that's just, there's so many levels you have to be acting on in order to turn in a performance like that. That's just freaking amazing to me. We got a little bit more about Billy Butcher's backstory. I still want to know what happened to his wife. Was she killed by a supe? I'm going to assume... I'm going to have to go back and try to listen to that scene again, because I think maybe I missed something about what happened with them and when they were looking after, or when they were going after Lamplighter, I guess. That seemed to be the incident that cost his wife her life.
No.
I'm going to have to go back and see what details I missed on that one. But yeah, the evangelical stuff was very on point. Like, modern evangelism has gone so far into commercialism and fascism and all these other crazy things lately, at least in the U.S. I mean, I've been privy to a lot of insane things that are going on in that community, like this whole, you know, like, what is it, the is it Five Mountains Dominionism or something like that? You know, this whole idea of, like, trying to take over the country by taking control of the different, quote, pillars of society and essentially forcing everyone in the country to be Christian and their particular brand of Christian, or else be deported or possibly even killed. I mean, there's some crazy shit going on in that community right now. And I think the whole thing with Homelander and that little festival or convention that they went to and everything was definitely spot on commentary on what's happening right now in that particular community. I'm not religious, obviously. I'm an atheist, but one of the things that I've been interested in my entire life has been mythology, and my major in college was comparative religion. So I feel confident when I say that the message of Christianity is very anathema to this idea of forcible conversion or forcing people to live as if they're part of your religion when they're not, and going to other people who aren't in your religion and telling them, oh, you're going to hell and you're a piece of shit sinner and all this other stuff. You know, I think a lot of people misunderstand the mythology of the quote-unquote New Testament, you know, that a lot of it was Jesus basically telling people, don't treat anybody like shit, because everyone essentially deserves to be treated like shit. So that means you too. You're not actually holier than anybody. So take that with you out into the world and treat everyone with respect, because you want to be treated with respect. And the truth of the matter is, you're not worth anything more than the guy that you're looking down on because he's not like you. You know, at least that's my two cents. I'm going to get off that soapbox now and get back to what this was actually about.
No politics, man.
The boys continue to impress me with their poor ability to stay under the radar. I was not surprised at all that something in our poor departed Pop Claw's house ended up being the undoing of at least one of them. You know, they are just terrible spies or agents or whatever the hell they are. They clearly have skills that indicate they had at least some level of career in a lot of these sort of things like police and special forces or whatever, but they are absolutely terrible at maintaining cover, operational security, and all these sorts of things. They walk around in public having conversations about their missions and their targets and evidence that they have. I don't know how they're going to survive to the end of this series. I just don't. when everything falls apart, it's going to be their own doing. Absolutely. But anyway, great episode. I'm definitely enjoying the hell out of this series when it's not hurting me in the heart, as it is wont to do. Very creative set pieces. The thing with the baby with the laser eyes was so fucking unique. I can't even say how unique it was. I've never seen anything like that before. That was amazing. And I'm really looking forward to seeing where this journey goes. Anyway, guys, come back next time as I will be checking out episode 6, which is entitled The Innocents. And that is not a title that makes me feel warm and fuzzy. That makes me think some pretty horrible shit's about to go down. And I think, remember that the season is 8 episodes long. So I would probably call it a day after episode 6 and finish up the season tomorrow or the next day. But I'm definitely enjoying it. I just need to give myself some time to edit these things as well, or else you'll literally never see. I'm trying to get a lot better about staying on task with the editing so that I can get these things up more quickly.
A few moments later.
So I had a little bit of a brainwave after recording my reaction to this episode. And it suddenly just dawned on me, you know, some of the ramifications of the discovery that Vought is manufacturing supers. It just suddenly clicked what's probably going on with the female. They took this person who probably was being trafficked and then pumped them full of V to see if they could create like a bootleg super. And A-Train was running V on the side to these people who were basically creating like a bootleg super operation.
So close yet so far.
Which is even extra brilliant. It would have been more brilliant if she had been Chinese, because there's always that whole thing going on in the international market about how China keeps allowing people to make just mass-produced counterfeit goods. And it could almost be a commentary on that, that, you know, Vought is making the original true supers, but you have these knockoffs coming out of like China or something. But I'm pretty sure she was Japanese, from, because I thought I heard her speaking, not her speaking, because she hasn't talked yet, I don't think, but all the stuff that she seemed to be sort of tuned into on the TV and everything was all in Japanese. So I'm guessing she's a Japanese person. But anyway, just thought about that afterward. You know, the ramifications of that are extreme. And, you know, Vought already was going to have a problem if the boys managed to leak a lot of stuff about how bad these soups are. But now, on top of that, the information that Vought is basically maintaining some sort of monopoly on new soups. I mean, how many of the soups are made by this Compound V? Are all of them that way? Like, going all the way back to Homelander, or did any of them naturally occur? Or have they just been spreading this stuff around to hospitals all over the place for, who knows, like 30, 40 years, producing superheroes without anybody being the wiser? This is a massive conspiracy, and that's going to be fun to watch play out. Anyway, that's all I had to say. I had to go ahead and make a little postscript here, because I was just literally walking around getting some water, and it just suddenly hit me like a freight train, like maybe like an A train. Ooh. Anyway, that's all I got. See you guys next time. Bye.